got trucks to pull, so make them extra full. I've never known a job that I couldn't do.
With a bit of help from me, maybe.
Never overlook a little engine. We could take you where you wanna go. We may have tiny track, but we'll get you there and back. And hold on to your hats, we don't go slow.
Look out, Thomas!
If you think the bigger's better, then you're making a mistake. The ocean isn't wetter than a tiny little lake. A cherry might be tastier than a great big cake. And we can turn around in half the time those big guys take. Never overlook a little engine. We have set our sights upon the sky. You need a lot of puff.
Big is not enough.
I've never known a job that I wouldn't try.
Me neither. Nor me.
Never overlook a little engine.
Like us. Okay, Thomas. Off you go.
They might not be ready for the ballast yet, though.
Look at that cool engine. jolly American railroaders, and braking is our trade. We're always on the go, both day and night. Throwing switches, making flag stops, along the line we go, and to see that all the trains are made up right. You bet we're always ready when called upon to go, no matter whether sunshine or in rain. And a jolly crew you'll find us if you will come and see us in that little red caboose behind the train. Two red lights we hang on each side, another one behind, in the evening when the sun is almost gone. You bet the lad that rides ahead will keep this in his mind, to see that all the trains are coming on. When we are near the station, how thoughtless out we go, all a singing or a whistling some refrain. Then we climb out on the hurricane deck and leave our coats inside on that little red caboose behind the train. And more dear than all the other coaches on the line. And the reason why we tell you, because it is our home, and we always try to keep it looking fine. Although we have no fashion lights, no velvet cushion chairs, everything inside just neat and plain. There's many an honest heart that beats beneath that rusty roof, in that little red caboose behind the train. Here's success to all those who ride upon the cars. May happiness always with you remain. For a jolly crew you'll find us if you will come and see us in that little red caboose behind the train. In that little red caboose behind the train. In that little red caboose behind the train.
They've broken our glass! They've broken our glass! Cried the coaches.
From the great Atlantic Ocean to the wide Pacific shore, from the green old Smoky Mountains to the Southland by the shore, she's mighty tall and handsome, and she's known quite well by all. She's a regular combination of Wabash Cannonball. Just listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as we glide across the woodlands, through the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engines, hear those lonesome hobos call. We're gliding through the jungles on Wabash Cannonball.
No one mentioned whistles.
States are dandy, so the people always say.
St. Louis, with Chicago by the way. From the hills of Minnesota, where the rippling waters fall, no changes can be taken on the Wabash Cannonball. Of the engines, hear those lonesome hobos call. We're gliding through the jungles on the Wabash Cannonball. We're gliding through the jungles on the Wabash Cannonball. We're gliding through the jungles on the Wabash Cannonball.
Can you hear something?
It sounds like Gordon, said Edward, and it ought to be Gordon. But Gordon never whistled like that.